hello everyone, and happy Friday to you all. Nicole here in the Creative Classroom, and I'm so excited to be here because we are talking all about, can you believe it? It's July, and it's 100 and some out, and we're talking about Christmas. But this has been such an exciting week because you all got to see a little bit of our kind of first wave of holiday releases. And as you heard me say in the booth tour video, if you haven't seen that, make sure you check that out because you can see all the things. This is the biggest holiday release we have ever had. So we're spreading it across 3 months, starting with July. So we launched a whole host of beautiful new dyes on, was it Tuesday? Tuesday the 20th. And I show off one of those here. Jump right in. I am playing today with our Kaleidoscope Argyle dye. Now this one has a few things, well, it's just so full of versatility. I'm like, there's so many things to talk about with it. But number one, it uses the Kaleidoscope kind of technology, Kaleidoscope style that we all love. And we love it because of its versatility. Change the colors, get a completely different look. So we love it for that. We also love it for the fact that it can be used on really any different size, shape card you have. So when Josie designed this, she designed this very thoughtfully. And that's what I want to show you today, is how you can use it on an A2 card, how you can use it on a mini slimline, and how you can use it on the full-size slimline. So with that, we shall jump in. Now I did all my die cutting ahead of time, so I went ahead and pre-cut everything because I know I don't want to bore you with that. But here's essentially what your die set's going to look like. There's another one over here that goes with it. But just like with all of our Kaleidoscope dies, it has three layer up. Actually, this one has a fourth. It's a bonus. And so what you will want to do is die cut them in different colors, tones, or you could even do it all one color, which I'll show you in a little bit. I did some samples with that. And so we have opted for, it's kind of light blue, the orange, and I have these. The orange is the one on the bottom. And then the gold in the middle. We tend to like to put kind of the gold or the silver, kind of the metallic one in the middle, just to give a little of that peeking through. But the beauty of these dyes is that once you start to layer them up, you get this really cool kaleidoscope effect. So again, I've already die cut these, so I'm gonna go ahead and just glue them. And again, this one has a bonus dye in the sense that it kind of peeks in from behind to give you another layer of color. Now you don't have to use that one, but again, it allows you to add a little more dimension and a little more color. So I'm gonna glue, and I know watching someone glue is probably one of the most boring things to do, but I'm doing it on camera because there is a little tip to this, and oh my gosh, I should have made sure my glue was flowing on air, and I didn't, and now I don't have a backup here, and I don't know what to do. All right, you're gonna see how the sausage is made, guys. This is what I do when it doesn't flow. So I go in from behind and try to work it this way. This is our Barely Arts glue. The reason it's so great is because, first of all, this tip, this really precise tip, which, as you can see, you have to be careful because it clogs. You got to keep your pin in it. Okay, my trick didn't work. Let's try it from the front again or from the top. See, there's just kind of a little I just can't quite get to. I can work it down. But this precise tip is so great for really fine gluing, like we're doing here with these kaleidoscopes. There we go. See, there we go. We got it worked out. And it also dries clear. So, and matte, more importantly. So if you happen to get a little bit of a glub, it's okay. And I just learned another tip. Josie taught us something earlier this week, that in order to kind of remove some of those glubs, she's like, just get a piece of scratch paper and daub it off. So let's do that. So the reason that I'm showing you how to glue these is because you're going to glue to your thinnest layer, which is the one there that's going to be on the top, and then kind of work your way down. Ooh, I had a little dangly there that I need to poke through. Grab my 2-in-1 here and just pop that little doohickey out. There we go. Somehow I missed that. And then you just keep layering it up and add glue to the next layer and the next layer. Now, we had a lot of questions from folks recently to say, how do I know which one is which? Like, how do I know which one goes on the top, which one goes on the bottom, and which one goes in the middle? And you can kind of tell if you look at surface area. The surface area is going to go on the bottom, like this one here, and then kind of your middle and your top. But they're not all as obvious. And I think it's the triangle, maybe. I'm not sure which one. But there's one that we launched in the past. Color on the back with this fourth bonus die. So I'm gonna just glue that on. Now, We're going to use this to create all different kinds of cards. I'm not going to glue the last one just yet, and I'm going to kind of show you how, again, this thoughtfully for all the different card shapes. Now, I'm going to take a break from gluing, so I'm going to put my pin back in here, because you see what happens. Already cut out that I want to show you kind of how this all works. And I have two already assembled. Now there's a fourth one here that I am going to assemble at some point, but I'm going to wait until I pull together my full-size slimline because there's a little trick to that. So you see this die that comes in your set. We cut those out of our darkest blue here. And the sizing on this was developed with the different card sizes in mind. So if you want to use this on an A2, then I love it because it creates your grid that just holds your little pieces and you know exactly where they go. And again, I would have a fourth, but I'm waiting on that one. So how cool, right? Now, one tip that I will share with you that I learned the hard way is that when you're doing it on an A2 card, I have found that a tiny pencil mark right here in the center to be able to line up that grid is helpful. Because when I first did it, guys, I was a little bit off. So putting that little pencil mark in there to line is very helpful, and then it just gets covered up right when you glue that down. Okay, so that's the A2. We got that, pretty straightforward. What if we go with the mini slimline? That are becoming pretty mainstream. So I'll tell you kind of a secret. It's not really a secret. It's just funny. It's just classic Nicole. I was playing with this and I was like, okay, so it goes like that. It goes like that. Well, how do we do it? And Josie, I said, Josie, show me. And she's like, okay, it's pretty easy. You actually make, if you cut out two, you create the center one by joining the two. And then it just, then you kind of naturally find where they fall off the card. So if you do it right, which I'm trying to get to, it really accommodates three just about perfectly. And then there you go. Again, you have your little frame or your grid. You drop in your little kaleidoscope pieces and you're ready to go. And the other die that I haven't shown you yet from, I'm not gluing it down because I am gonna glue down the full size slimline. But the other die in the set that I haven't shown you yet is sitting off camera. I kind of joke that this is our pool table die because it looks like there's a bunch of little balls from by putting these on the little joints. See that? So I wanted to show you what that die did as well. Okay, so again, thoughtfully designed little grid here. This is designed so that it takes up the full slimline size and bleeds off just ever so slightly, okay? So here is our grid, and I probably I can look at that, there's grid paper here. Okay, so now I have to do math though, guys. This is challenging. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and a half. Well, duh, it's 8 and a half. I knew that. 1, 2, 3, 4 and a quarter. And it looks like this comes down a tiny bit, so I'm gonna put it right about there. Okay, cool. Brush it off, and I'm like, why isn't it brushing off? Because it's a pencil mark, doofus. I shouldn't say doofus. I've coined that term, and now my daughter calls me a doofus all the time. So she's a little parrot, aren't they all? All right, again, just adding a little bit of glue here. I'm not going to take the glue all the way to that little ball because it will partially bleed off. And we'll glue down one side. Again, lining up that little pencil mark, trying to make it as straight as I can. There we go. And then tacking that down. I'm pretty straight, even a little bit off, but that's okay. And then I'll do the other side and tack that down. Now, a lot of the samples and stuff we've done here, the team has put like embossing folders. We have these great new slimline embossing folders of really, really basic designs, projects to a whole other level. And they're stripes, big dot, and a diagonal stripe. And so putting that texture behind this too can take it a little bit further. I'm keeping it pretty simple for this one, and I think even as simple as we're going, again, that kaleidoscope just, it just sings. It's kind of grid laid down. And now we get to place our kaleidoscopes. Now, the reason I held off on the last one is because I'm going to cheat a little bit. I don't want to cut this out another time. I'm going to take this one that I've already done, and we're going to cut it down the middle and use half of it here and half of it here. Now, the key, though, is if you glue them all together and try to make that cut, it's going to be a really difficult cut to make. Okay? To do it, two at a time. I should have practiced this. Confession time. Isn't this why they call it try day? Because we try new things on air. You see that we all make mistakes, too. And again, I've got a little bit of those chads hanging out there. All right, I'm going to try to take it right up the middle. Here we go. Bam. Gosh, those shears are great. Okay, so two of my layers are cut. And now I'm going to glue them down. And then I will go cut the other pieces. And hope that this all works out. I think it will. Now, another thing about kaleidoscope that I don't know if you're aware of is that if you look closely, most all of the kaleidoscopes have these little circle areas. So these, like this area right here. And those were sized perfectly to accommodate our... Okay, so again, applying glue to the top layer. We'll dot that off a little bit. Right, but my daughter is